mellow out a little bit. We're just gonna mellow it out a little bit with the original Gangster Convention, the founding father of Fun on the Road, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Jason Mann! Okay, this part of the program is we call What Did Rich Say? So you can say, what did Rich say again? Okay. What did Rich say? What did Rich say? Who knows? Let's all find out what Rich said. Thank you. All right, so here's what I said. I said, Robbie said, what a man, or what a good man.
I'm pretty sure that heard me.
But I don't remember what I said, that's cute.
What a man, what a mighty good man.
I said, he didn't get a haircut.
What a man, what a mighty good man.
Wearing casual shoes.
What a man, what a mighty good man.
Hat in his pocket.
What a man.
Because he had a hat in his pocket.
Right. What a man, what a mighty good man.
He's standing right there.
Okay, all true.
They're all factual. Anyway, Jason, intro. You can bank on it being fact-based. So, are we gonna do a little collective?
Yes, I forgot to tell you guys that guitar's tuned to standard. So,
standard.
So, I was gonna ask these guys to sing a little song with me, if that's alright. Y'all.
Yeah.
to sing another tune with me. We got a little fun side project called The Station Breaks. And this is a tune off of that. This is a tune off of that album.
That's right. Did you ever see Station Breaks or the whole thing? Did you see Station Breaks and everything? Yeah, we started this band together called The Station Breaks. We made an album and a self-titled album, also called The Station Breaks, and we're really excited about it, very proud of it. And, so check it out, it's like out there somewhere on the interwebs. This is a song called Stowaway. Thank you. nightmare.
There's a freight train racing down the track. I don't know where it's gonna lead, but it's not coming back. He that was so blowing, gonna catch it.
Hi guys!
Hi!
How y'all doing? My name is Jason Mann. And for those of you who you probably already found out, but if you happen to lean over to the person next to you and say, is that dude in the blue shirt? I was on the show in season 4. Played voice coming out of the radio. It's some of my best acting work, I do say so myself. I'm really excited that they bring me along with some of these things and let me play it for y'all, because it's always, honestly, not just saying, it's the best crowd any musician can play for. So I'm always excited to do it. So they give me this Q&A, which I've kind of turned into a concert. So I call it a quamcert. And if anyone has any questions, thoughts, concerns, suggestions, feel free to say them into the microphone. And I will do my best to say something funny in response. Sometimes it works. Hi, how are you? I know the feeling.
If you could pick any one genre of music to listen to just every day for the rest of your life, what genre would it be?
It'd be soul music, old kind of classic soul. I feel like when growing up, I always loved music. I always loved listening to music. But I grew up actually in Virginia, so I actually just moved back to Virginia, so I'm currently a Virginian, all my friends listened to country music growing up, and I loved country music too, but for some reason I loved Sam Cooke, Otis Redding, Marvin Gaye, something about those voices. That's just what I always wanted to listen to. So, I mean, I was happy to listen to anything anybody was playing, classic rock or country or death metal. It's fine. But if I was picking a tune, it was probably going to be one of those dudes.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Speaking of those dudes.
Left my home in Georgia. watching the tide roll away. Ooh, I'm just gonna sit on the dock in the bay and waste some time. You have a question?
We were waving.
Oh, I love it. Okay.
Hi, how did you get started in music? I belong to a handbell choir, and do you ever think of using handbells for some of your music?
So really you have two questions.
Well, yeah. Kind of two-parter.
I like that. Like, hey, how did you get started? Also hire me. I approve. Well done. how did I get started? I started playing guitar a little bit in high school, but I didn't really perform. I went to college, and I tried to play basketball. I went to William & Mary down in Williamsburg, and I was very excited that I was going to the school, and I was very excited to try and walk on the basketball team, and then they were not very excited to have me on the basketball team. So when I was walking back from my meeting with the coach, wondering what I was gonna do with my time, all of this excess time that comes when you don't play sports, which I've never experienced before, I saw a sign that said, hey, if you like to drink, and you like to travel, and you like to sing, join this a cappella group. And at the time, strangely enough, I did not drink. I was 17, so I guess that's probably a good thing. But I was like, well, I don't necessarily drink, but I like to travel. I think I can sing. I don't really know. Well, thank you. Now I feel confident saying that I am capable of singing. But at the time, I didn't really know. And so I tried out the soccer color group and wound up being like one of the three dudes who got in. I had 100 that tried out or something. And I was like, oh, maybe I can sing a little bit. So I was in that group for 5 years, and that's really what taught me everything I know about music. So my musical education was a little different because I learned everything vocally. Because we would break down songs, you know, people would sing the bass part, and they would sing the guitar part, and somebody would beatbox for the rhythm. So it taught me a ton about blend and chords and, you know, thirds and building and harmony. But yeah, I learned it all with my voice, so that's my musical education. And also, to answer your second question, yeah, I'll jam with anybody, so that is super fun. Yeah. Handbell it up. Thank you for the question. Hi.
Hi.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good.
So my question is, how did you get into songwriting? Because I sort of dealt with it myself and it's difficult. At least for me. So I'm wondering, how did you get into songwriting instead of just, you know, going along with acapella and seeing what other people
are writing? I feel like songwriting is a muscle, you know? So people who haven't done it before is the skinny dude that sits down on the weight bench, which is gonna be super hard, but if you just do it every day, you just have to do it every single day, you will get better, and you'll get stronger, and it will become easier. You can continue to challenge yourself so that it doesn't ever get too easy, because you don't want to do the same thing every time. Because for me, now, I feel like I could sit down in an hour and write you a three-chorded love song that wouldn't be terrible. Wouldn't win any songwriting awards,
but it wouldn't be unbearable to listen to. Because that's what I did when I first started. That's just what inspired me, and that's what I listened to, and that's what I wrote. I wrote, you know, very simple love songs. But I try to challenge myself. So if I sit down to write a breakup song, which I haven't experienced a breakup in a very long time, because I was married, I'm a very childhood boy, thank you. You guys seem surprised. So for me to sit down and write a breakup song is kind of challenging, because that's not what I'm faced with, that's not what I'm experiencing. So to answer your question, I would say, how did I start? I just did it. Just started writing songs, and they were terrible. I'm not lying. Like, they were not good. Some of them I even recorded and put out on an album. If you just keep doing it and you keep challenging yourself, you'll get better. That's all.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Hi.
Hello.
I like your mustache.
Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Okay, so my question is, I know sometimes you like to sing duets with people, like you and Jensen have sung together before and other people, but when you're going to do that, how do you guys decide what song you're going to sing? Because I know you must have like separate songs that you're passionate about.
Sure. You know, depending on the specific scenario that you're talking about, in the beginning, before, say, Jensen, for example, had as much musical experience as he does now, it was usually me saying, hey, dude, you sound good singing this, let's sing this. And he'd say, cool. Now, 10 years into him playing and performing and singing and you know, being a rock star, he has a pretty good idea of what he likes and what he sounds good on and what he wants to work on. So currently, I'll send him a list of 3 or 4 songs I think he would sound good on, and he'll say, yeah, you know, I like this one, that one, I don't really want to do that one. What do you think about this tune or this tune? And we just kind of go back and forth and you know, just kind of talk about music. What's up for the cover of the Friends album, when we did Simple Man, we had our date in the studio booked, and then we didn't really have a song. We were going back and forth, say, what about this, what about that, and, you know, and then I got up to Vancouver and we were going to the studio the very next day, and we were like, what are we going to sing? Because we hadn't decided on a song. We were going to the studio the next day. And we were kind of getting stressed about it, just because we were like, we're nothing, we don't love anything, you know, like, there's nothing that we're like, yes, we have to do that. And so I said, well, let's just forget about it. If we have to cancel the studio, we can cancel the studio. It's not a big deal. Let's just jam, you know? Let's just play music and, you know, whatever. If we have to do schedule, it's fine. And then the first song he played was Simple Man. And I was like, well, obviously we're recording that song. That was awesome. So that's how that happened. And I think we're supposed to go to the studio pretty soon again. And also have not prepared the song. So we'll see what happens there. Yeah. But thank you for the question. Hi.
Hello, sir. How are you doing?
Really good.
Glad to speak to you. Your speech says hi.
Hi.
Quick question. Would you ever consider doing an a cappella album? Just leave the a cappella.
Yeah, of course. I think I would probably be more inclined to include a few a cappella tunes on an album rather than do an a cappella album. Because I just remember from Covers Your Friends album when we did the song we just sang, which was Wagon Wheel. It's got a 4-part harmony in it. And I just remember sitting with the engineer for hours mixing that harmony. Just because, you know, you've got 4 voices, and when you're singing, the the room or in a mic, you're listening to each other and you're kind of adjusting your volume so that you match. But when you're sitting in the studio with all four of those voices with complete control of their volume, you're like, yeah, I think I need this harmony more. I can't really hear Rich. Let's turn Rich up. No, that's too loud. Well, maybe keep that there. Let's turn Rob up. No, that's too loud compared to the music. And turn, you know, it's just, it's so, so many aspects of it, you know, that it's crazy. Eventually, you just have to walk away from it and be like, it's fine. It's good, you know? So I think a whole album of that would drive me crazy. But yeah, I love acapella. That's where I obviously got to start. And I'd sing in a group called Stairwells at William & Mary. And I would love to do a reunion and get some of those guys out and do a couple tunes. I think that would be really, really fun.
Overtune does have some really great recording
booths. What's that?
Overtune has some great recording booths.
Richmond, yeah. That the first studio I ever saw the inside of was a place called Rainmaker Studio in Richmond, Virginia. We did a Stairwells album there. So that was my first time singing in a booth. Thanks for the question. Right now, that one's my favorite one. Thank you for the question. Hi.
Ordinarily, your songs are so warm and rich and meaningful, but I was wondering, do you ever do anything a little more on the lighter side, like with parody songs, like Weird Al Yankovic, or have you ever thought of doing anything like that?
You know, not full-on parody, like where I write it from a humorous perspective, but I have done a few tunes where I'll do a mashup, and the song that I insert is a little bit tongue-in-cheek. So, you know, singing a Prince song and putting Meghan Trainor's song in the middle of it, stuff like that, where it's humorous, but it's not necessarily a full-on Weird Al tune. Should I write some Weird Al tunes?
Anything when you're singing always sounds good, so that's
good. Oh, thank you. Very, very kind of you. Thank you. Hi.
Hi. Covers with Friends was obviously amazing.
Thank you so much.
What was it like working with people who didn't necessarily have some of the experience before?
Honestly, it was a blast. It was really, really fun. I think it played to my strengths in music, because I give not as much anymore, but I used to give lessons, and I used to teach, and I used to do a lot of stuff. So I was self-taught, and so I had a lot of patience for music that sounds really bad on its way to sounding really good. Not that any of those people sounded bad. I'm not saying that at all. I'm just saying that hearing someone sing and knowing that that's not where it is going to stay is really fun for me. I like hearing the potential in someone's voice and taking time to try and get it to where I think it can go in the studio. And actually during that process, working with people who hadn't necessarily been in the studio that much was something that made me realize that I really love producing. And I love being in a studio when I'm not the dude singing in the microphone. I love being the dude singing in the microphone too, but you know, when I did that covers album, I was like, oh, this is actually fun being in control booth and trying to help people reach their potential. And Gil was already pretty much at his potential. I just kind of helped him stylize a few things, but it was really fun working with him. And that was the first time I'd done a whole album for someone else that I didn't sing on at all. And I was curious if I would really enjoy that, and I did. It was a really fun process. So I'm looking forward to doing Brianna's album for her. And yeah, it's gonna be good. Her song on the new Covers with Friends album is gonna blow y'all's socks off. Pretty awesome. And yeah, so. Did I answer your question? I just kind of talked for a long time and I don't even remember where I started.
Yes.
I got it?
Yeah.
I covered it? Okay, good.
Thank you.
Thank you for the question. Hi. How are you?
Good, how are you?
Really good.
So I am a band teacher for a Catholic school.
Cool.
And my question for you is, so I play a lot of different instruments because we have to teach a lot of
children.
Do you only play the guitar? Do you have any desire to play anything else?
I really only perform with the guitar. I play a little bit of a bunch of stuff. Who was it? Was it John Lennon that said, I'm a musician, so if you give me a tuba, I'll figure out how to make music with it or something along those lines. I kind of feel that way. You know, if you do music for a living, you can probably figure it out because you know what it takes to learn a song, and you know what it takes to train your hands to do the things that you need to do to make the chords and stuff. So whether it's a guitar or a ukulele or a piano or whatever, you know, You're not gonna sit down and be an aficionado, but you can probably sit down and play something simple. Especially for a singer, I think, because even though guitar is what I play on stage, I was kind of felt like my voice was my instrument and my guitar was the accompaniment. So if I play something on the piano, I don't need to go crazy with my hands. I just need to kind of set a bass, you know, pad so that I can sing and people know what song I'm singing. That's a little more difficult with the harmonica. But I'd like to figure out how to sing and play that at the same time. I'm working on that currently. Thank you for the question.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello. You already answered the first part of my question, which is what acapella group were you in? Incidentally, the internet doesn't know that. The second question was, what was your favorite solo you did while you were in the stairwells, and could you sing some of it for us?
Good question. So, like I said, I didn't really fancy myself as a singer when I joined the stairwells, and so I was extremely nervous. My first solo was Billy Joel. Oh, what's the name of the song?
It's the matter with the clothes I'm wearing, can't you tell it's just as white?
What is it? Yeah. So that was my first solo, and I remember it very vividly. We sang, we performed at Parents Weekend, and it was like 5,000-6,000 people in the stands, and we were the first group that went, and mine was the first solo. And I kid you not, to this day, I've sang on television in front of millions of people. I've done, you know, Saturday Night Special's got 1,000 people in there going crazy. So, I mean, I've done a lot of singing since that point, and I don't think I'll ever be more nervous than I was that day. I still remember the feeling, my legs were shaking. And I'm not a dude that gets super nervous, usually. I'll get some butterflies. I'm shaking, still remember. And I sang super quietly. I think I had my hands in my pockets. That was a good question, but that was my least favorite solo. My favorite solo, my freshman year, I got Brown Eyed Girl. So that was the song that that I would sing.
got me leading, got me down on my knees.
Oh,
if I may, are you going to go to sell CDs and sign CDs and do what you do so well right now?
Yeah.
That's awesome. Jason Mann's selling his records in the
Thank you guys so much for hanging out. It was really fun.
Here we go!